Lion, the Witch, and the Wardrobe. Some journeys take us far from home. Some adventures lead us to our destiny. Some stories lead us to far better things than anything we leave behind. Our chronicle follows four children through a seemingly ordinary wardrobe into a fantastical world they never knew had been waiting for them all along. Let us go and take the adventure that shall fall to us, for the world is full of magic things, just patiently waiting for our senses to grow sharper.
Our king will soon return.
We keep hoping, we keep praying. He hasn't been
have more faith.
I think Mr. Centaur is right.
I do too.
I think. You better break up this meeting in a hurry.
Why is that, Mr. Centaur?
Shh. Listen.
Come on, you! Now I'm off! Got it!
Oh, that sounds like Fenrisul.
Not that scoundrel.
I'm terribly sorry, Captain.
Where's Tumnus the Thorn?
Poor Tumnus. Whatever did he get himself mixed up in that bad business?
Whatever the reason, he's in a mess. We will be too overseen by the press for Fenrisul.
Mr. Beaver's right. Goodbye, everybody.
Goodbye. Wait! Don't forget to hope and pray that our king will soon return.
Who is thus here? What was that flurry of activity?
Well, probably just a blizzard, Captain.
Probably the enemy. But they scatter swiftly on the arrival of Fenris Ulf and another queen's secret police.
Yes.
Now, why were you late coming to your post again this morning?
But I really don't think I'll be needed here, Captain. After all, a child of Adam and Eve has never come this way before.
But one will come someday.
Yes.
And it's your job to capture him! That child of Adam and Eve may belong to him.
Maybe a child of Adam and Eve will never come this way. But if one does, then I can capture him and take him to the Queen. Oh, but that would be wrong, I think. Oh dear, I'm perplexed. As usual, I don't know what to do. Oh, except what I usually do when I'm perplexed. Play my pipe.
In
Narnia. You'll be so glad you came. brothers and sisters will be joining us too, so I can show them all of our beautiful countryside and maybe introduce them to our queen.
Everything seems so magical.
That's because it is. Follow me, and you can visit anywhere you would like in Narnia, quick as a wink. For instance, you may visit the distant castle of Caer Paravel, or you may wish to take a trip to the home of our mighty queen. Or perhaps you'd like to picnic on the great stone table, or visit two of our horse friends, Mr. and Mrs. Weedon. Or maybe take a trip to my own home of the moon. Thomas Towers! Yes, I like fancy names for simple things.
It's a fascinating place.
Oh, it's perfect for the imagination. With a bit of help from our wood friends. Thank you, forest friends.
Bye-bye. There's only one small problem here, as I see it.
Yes?
It's so cold. It was summer just a few minutes ago, where I came from, I mean.
Just here, take my scarf.
Thank you.
In the land of spare wools?
Yes.
Yes. Well, I must admit, it is always winter in Narnia, but you will soon warm up to it, I hope. Meanwhile, why don't we repair to Thomas Towers for a spot of tea then to warm us up?
Very well, I can see no harm in that.
Yes, none at all. Oh, look, our forest friends have even already prepared the tea for us. All that's left is the sugar. Would you like one or two?
Two.
One. And here comes the second. And two.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. Hope that's still your liking.
It's delicious.
Good.
I'm very glad to have met you, Mr. Thomas. You're a very nice song. Oh.
I hope not. men of a spy saw me. Oh, well, I feel ever so much better about everything. From now on, I'm going to be much
to death!
No, your treachery has been detected.
No.
You had a human in your very grasp when you let it go!
I'm sorry.
Don't the queen, dear.
No.
Tumnus the traitor! I hereby order this house destroyed.
No, please, not my fault.
You won't be me.
No, not my fault, please. What is that?
This document will serve no
good. No, please, I'm sorry.
Lucy, you're great. It's just a big old wardrobe, like any other big old wardrobe, with lots of coats inside. It's stuffy and dark and cold. It was warm in the wardrobe.
But now we're in Narnia.
Narnia?
He didn't believe me. I wanted to tell Peter and Susan as well, because you were the first one I found, and I wanted to get back here as soon as possible.
I thought you were teasing. Well, I guess you were right after all.
Now, the first thing we must do is see if Mr. Thomas, the font, is safe. I hope the White Witch didn't get him.
Witch? Because a witch here in Narnia?
An evil witch who makes it always winter and never Christmas in Narnia. In Narnia, is Mr. Thomas' home? I thought it was right over here. We have to go look for him. Come on, Edmund.
I'll stay right here, thank you. I have no desire to go chasing off after some silly fawn. I'll be here in the lamppost. If I stay. I'm not sure I'd like it here.
Please don't leave without me. I'll be back as soon as I make sure Mr. Thomas is safe.
Narnia, eh? I didn't believe Lucy. But she was right. It's a fascinating place, I'll admit. But all this business about fawns and witches and...
Hold there!
Yes, Your Majesty!
I smell an intruder!
You there! Me? Yes, you! Kneel in the presence of the Almighty Ruler of Narnia! But I am the Lower! That's more like it!
What prey are you?
My name is Edmund.
Is that how you address a queen?
I'm sorry, Your Majesty. I thought you were a witch.
A witch! Oh, I am a queen! The Queen of Narnia. Now, I repeat. What are you?
I'm a boy. Your Majesty.
A boy? A boy. Did you hear that, dwarf? A boy.
He must be a son of Adam.
He looks more like an idiot. Tell me, boy, how did you enter my dominion?
Through a wardrobe, Your Majesty. I'm not sure exactly how it happened, but in an instant, I was here.
A wardrobe? A passageway from the other world? The world of men! This could ruin everything! This could even be the start of the dreaded prophecy! Unless... my poor child, how cold you look. Blow!
Yes!
Bring him something warm to drink.
Thank you, Your Majesty.
Tell me, Edmund, my dear son of Adam, are there any more of you? Humans, I mean, in these parts?
My sister, Lucy, was looking for a fawn.
Oh, She must be the daughter of Eve who escaped from that fool, Tumnus. Let's see. You and Lucy, you say? That's only two. The prophecy said there would be four. So there's nothing to worry about. Unless... you don't have any other brothers or sisters, do you?
Yes, Peter and Susan.
What?! Where are they?
They're still house for visiting. On the other side of the wardrobe.
Edmund, Lucy, Peter, and Susan. Two sons of Adam, two daughters of Eve. This is horrible!
What's wrong, Your Majesty?
Nothing. Nothing at all. I just meant it's horrible
that your brother and sisters aren't here with us now.
I would take you all back to my castle. I would make them the duke and duchesses of this land, but you, dear Edmund, because you're special, and I found you first, I would make you the Prince of Narnia.
Really?
And someday, you would be king.
King? You mean it.
Ah, here is your delightful drink. Sweet and creamy and delicious.
It's wonderful.
You must have something to eat as well. Tell me, what is your favorite candy?
Oh, that's easy. Turkish Delight.
Well, then Turkish Delight it shall be. Enjoy, my little prince.
It's the best Turkish Delight I've ever tasted. May I have more?
Of course. Back at my castle, I have rooms filled with Turkish delights.
Let's go there right now.
First, you must fetch the others.
Oh, I remember the time.
Now! My dear, bring them to my castle. It is between those two hills. You can't miss it. You'll smell the Turkish delight all the way. Come, dwarf!
I'm coming! Your Majesty.
We must prepare for our esteemed guests. Oh, Edmund, my precious. Don't tell the others about me just yet. I want them to be surprised when they see me. Let's keep this visit our little secret. Don't spare the whip on the wall! We have much to do in a short time!
Keep moving! You can't!
Yes, I'll bring Peter and Susan to the queen. I'm glad to know she was queen, or else I might have mistaken her for a witch.
Edmund, this is terrible. I can't spy Mr. Tumnus anywhere.
Then perhaps we should go get Peter and Susan to help us find him.
You really want to? I didn't think you liked us here.
Well, maybe the place does deserve a second look after all. Especially the large castle between those two hills.
Good, we're gonna go get Peter and Susan.
And this time we'll get some coats out of the wardrobe. It's cold here.
As I told you, it's all the witch's fault.
Oh, go on, Lucy. There's no such thing as a witch in Narnia.
We'll just have to wait.
Yes, this other business is much more important. Oh, look, there's the unicorn. We'll tell her.
Miss Unicorn, over here if you will.
Oh, God, it's you. I was afraid it was that awful Fenris Ulf.
She left some time ago.
Glad that the unfortunate Mr. Tumnus behind her.
Well, how do you know?
They passed right by us. We hid behind the dam.
But Fenris Ulf did not see us. But Mr. Tumnus did, and he dropped this so that we would find it.
What is it?
We're not sure. We think it belongs to a human.
It has the scent of the daughter of Eve.
You think that a human has been here?
And that Tumnus let her go. That's why he was in such trouble with Fenris Ulf.
So where is this human now, if there ever was one?
Who knows?
If she's smart, she left Narnia the moment she had the chance, never to return.
Or to return with others.
Others? You mean humans?
Perhaps. Remember the prophecy.
Two sons of Adam and two daughters of Eve. Is it possible?
Who knows? We'll have to wait and see.
Listen! I just heard the most wonderful news. They say he has returned in these parts.
Our king?
They say he is due to go to the stone table any time now.
Oh, that is wonderful news.
Mr. Centaur, we are expecting the arrival of children. Human children. They could be here any minute. They reach him? The prophecy will be fulfilled!
Well, what if the witch gets to them first?
Well, then we must protect them from the moment they arrive in Narnia until they reach the stone table.
And keep them hidden from the witch.
Exactly.
But which one of us can protect them? They might be afraid of me.
They may not trust me. Unicorns all only make believe in their world.
Mr. and Mrs. Beaver, will you help them? Protect them from danger?
But
it's this way, come on!
I still don't believe you. It's here somewhere.
Look for the lamppost!
Here they come. Will you please help them?
But
of course! I'll go fix some food for dinner.
Mr. Centaur, let us go see who gives you first.
True!
Agreed. Let us go quickly.
But aren't they afraid of me too? But they don't trust me. I'd better fight till I get my wits together.
Just a little further. That's it.
Are you sure it's this way?
Yes, I can see the lamppost. Follow me. Now are you convinced, Peter?
Yes. I apologize, Lou, for not believing you.
It's so different. It is very cold.
That's why we borrowed these coats from the wardrobe, Susan.
Well, what do we do first?
Explore, of course. Let's go in that direction.
Don't forget where the lamppost is. That's our landmark. We'll need to find it when we wish to return home.
Well, I think we should go back home now. It's scary here.
Don't be such a goose, Susan. Where is this adventure?
Whether we stay here or not, we must at least try to find Mr. Tumnus.
But you tried already. You couldn't even find his house.
I could have sworn this was right over there.
Look. What's that?
A message of some kind. The former occupant of these premises, Juan Tumnus, is under arrest and awaiting trial on account of high treason against Her Imperial Majesty Jadis, Queen of Narnia.
Signed, Fenris Ulf, Captain of the Secret Police. Long live the Queen.
No!
Who is this Queen, Lou?
She isn't a queen at all! She's a horrible witch who makes it always winter and never Christmas in Narnia!
It doesn't seem safe here. How about just going home?
We must at least try to rescue Mr. Tumnus. It's my fault he's in trouble.
I suppose Lou is right.
Very well. Let this place worries me.
Where should we look first?
I wish to look for something to eat.
Oh, you're always thinking about your stomach.
And you're always thinking about your clothes and your hair and how you look.
Well, if I look like anyone...
At least you two stop acting like brothers!
I just wish I knew where Mr. Tumnus was imprisoned.
Why do we go to that castle between the two hills?
Very well.
Perhaps it'll be warmer there.
What was that?
Nothing, kitty cat. Let's go.
Who's there?
Are you the sons of Adam and daughters of Eve?
Where some of them?
Quick, follow me. We're not safe here.
What do you mean?
Many of the forest creatures are our friends, but some are on her side, if you know what I mean. Now come, let us go.
Wait a minute. I have to get to the castle. Who wants us to assist a beaver?
Stop being so smug, Ed. Pay attention to him.
But how do we know if he's a friend?
Oh, here is my token.
My handkerchief!
Mr. Thomas dropped it so that we would know to expect you. Now please, come quickly. We must get you safely to our king.
Your king?
Aslan.
Aslan?
The very name makes me feel brave and adventurous.
The name sounds a bit like Australian music to me.
It warms me up and makes me feel like summer.
It gives me a bad feeling, like some mysterious horror.
Ed, what is wrong with you? You're acting so strangely.
Well, I was supposed to act in a strange place. I should go to the castle.
I say we go with Mr. Beaver.
I too.
And I.
Three against one, Ed. Come on.
Mrs. Beaver, we're here. I found her.
sons of Adam and daughters of Eve.
Oh, welcome, welcome. Come in, come in. I've just prepared some dinner for you, fresh from the smokehouse outside.
Looks delicious.
Yes, indeed, I'm famished.
We're very grateful for your hospitality. Aren't we, Ed?
I prefer Cherish's light.
What's that, dear?
He said it looks perfect. He's delighted.
Now, before we let us each say a word of thanks and hope for the coming event. Good. Now enjoy the meal.
Oh, how very honored we are to have the children of the prophecy.
What do you mean, children of the prophecy? I'm not even sure what a prophecy means.
It's something that's predicted, Lou. Something that will probably happen.
Oh, what is the prophecy, Mr. Beaver?
It's told in form of a rhyme. Wrong will be made right when Aslan comes in sight. At the sound of his roar, sorrows will be no more. When he bares his teeth, winter will meet its death. When he shakes his mane, we shall have spring again.
Who is Aslan? A man?
Certainly not. He is king of the wood and son of the great emperor beyond the sea. He is a lion, the great lion. We've heard he may be here in Narnia even as we speak. If it's true, we'll take you to the stone table early in the morning so that you may meet him.
And help fulfill the prophecy.
But how do we fit into all this?
We still understand about the prophecy.
But you will. Listen to the rest of the rhyme. When Adam's flesh and Adam's bone sits a caravel and throne, the evil time will be over and done.
What does that mean, Adam's flesh and Adam's bone?
It means humans.
You're the first humans to ever come to Narnia.
But what about the queen and the dwarf? Aren't they human?
You mean the witch and the dwarf? She'd like you to believe they're human, but they're not. They're evil through and through, not a drop of human blood in them.
This caravel that you mentioned, how many thrones are there?
Four. Two for the sons of Adam.
And two for the daughters of Eve. Oh.
And when they're filled, it will mean the end of the witch's reign and her light.
Two and two.
You are the four.
It is quite a responsibility.
It's quite a necessity. And we count on you to help fulfill the prophecy.
Even though the adventure will be filled with danger.
I, for one, am ready.
I do. And I.
What about you, Ed?
Ed? Edmund?
Wherever did he go?
Perhaps to get some air? Do you think he became ill? He hasn't looked well since we got here.
He mentioned something about a witch. Also a dwarf. We knew nothing of the dwarf. Is there such a person?
Yes. He drives the witch's sleigh.
That means that he's met them.
Yes, and undoubtedly eaten her food. He had that look. He is surely under her spell.
He's probably well on his way to her castle by now.
Then we must be there and stop him.
No, no. You mustn't go near the witch.
She would turn you all to stone with her magic wand.
But we have to get Ed back. All four of us need to fulfill the prophecy.
What shall we do?
If Aslan is indeed in Narnia, he will know what to do.
Then we will set out to the stone table first thing tomorrow.
I say we set out right now. When Edmund tells the witch where we are, she'll come here and turn us all to stone.
Oh, this is the place, all right?
Oh, no.
Is that?
I'm afraid so.
Seems the witch has arrived already. There's no time for escape. Be brave, young friends.
You in there! Make yourself presentable to an esteemed visitor.
It's the dwarf.
We were prepared in continuation.
Now, of course, we're elves.
What's the difference? Either way, the witch is going to come in and...
Wait a minute, Peter. There is a difference. An elf, you said.
An elf, I said.
Elves aren't threats at all. If I'm not mistaken.
You're not mistaken. He's mistaken. You are Lucy.
And you're clever. Very clever. Because you know my name.
We know.
And you can only know my name, all of our names, if you travel to one of whose everybody's name.
Nathan.
Father Christmas!
Is Father Christmas actually here?
After all these years?
In flesh or in the fur, as it were.
Ta-da! Father Christmas!
The powers of the witch have kept me away for some time now, but lately I've felt stronger, more like myself. That's why I'm making my rounds again.
Well, they say Aslan is on the move.
That must be the answer. Well, are you ready for your gifts? First, Mr. Beaver, I have repaired your dam and mended the leak.
Oh,
a simple thank you suffice.
Thank you.
And Mrs. Beaver, in the room next to the smokehouse,
yes.
I've left for you a brand new sewing machine. Son of Adam.
Yes, sir.
These are your presents. They are tools, not toys. The time to use them is perhaps near at hand. The sword and the shield are yours. Bear them well. Susan, daughter of Eve, these are for you. Use the bow only in the greatest of need. Blow this horn when you're in trouble, and help of some kind will come to you.
Thank you, sir.
Lucy, younger daughter of Eve, in this bottle is a cordial made from the juice of fire flowers. If you or your friends are ever hurt, a few drops will restore you. And this dagger is to defend yourself, but use it only when absolutely necessary.
Thank you, Father Christmas.
Well, we must be on our way. We have many more stops to make tonight. It's wonderful to be working again. Merry Christmas to all of you. And long live the true king.
Long live the true king.
And we must be on our way as well. We must travel quietly and cautiously.
Okay.
The winter spies are everywhere. The gifts of Father Christmas may well be needed before our journey's end. Now come, let us go.
I shall never allow the prophecy to come true. Never! Blah!
Yes!
Make ready the sleigh for our journey. We must leave immediately.
Your Majesty, I'm afraid we'll have to walk. The wolves cannot travel without snow. They'll sink into the mud.
Then we shall go on
Howard!
Fenrisulf, chief of my secret police, you are the quickest of all my army. Go ahead of us. Overtake the humans before they reach the stone table. Kill anything in your path, especially the beavers for harboring the enemy.
I hear and obey, Your Majesty.
Yes!
Tie the hands of this human and drive him ahead of us with your whip.
With pleasure, Your Majesty!
But Your Majesty, what about my Turkish delight? You said...
Silence! Food.
But I'm hungry.
Enough of this stalling. We must be off. Move.
Mr. Beaver and Mrs. Beaver. But where is the other son of Adam?
He has tried to betray his brother and sisters, and has joined the White Witch, O Aslan.
It was partly my fault, Aslan. We were arguing. That may have pushed him in the wrong direction.
Please, Aslan, can anything be done to save Edmund?
All shall be done, but it may be harder than you think. Meanwhile, let a feast of celebration be prepared in yon pavilion. You will find food and drink in abundance there. Peter and I shall join you momentarily. Son of Adam?
Yes, Aslan.
Look far into the distance where Narnia meets the sea. There is a castle.
I can see it.
It is Caer Pervel of the Four Brooms. If the prophecy is to be fulfilled, you, your brother, and your sisters will all sit in this room.
Yes. Mr. and Mrs. Beaver explained it to us. But don't all four of us have to sit together?
Yes.
Then what about Edmund? What if the White Witch... What was that?
My sister's horn.
Father Christmas must have been right in front of trouble. Something dreadful must have happened.
It is a monster!
She said it's right!
Right behind us!
Can you tell who or what it is?
It seems to be...
I'm afraid it is.
Famous old captain of the Witch's secret police.
Aslan. Would you protect us from him?
No, but you will.
Me?
Stand back! Let the prince win his spurs!
Well, so the great Aslan has returned! My queen will be interested in this news. But before I go, would the mighty one like to test my strength? Are you so afraid of Fenrisulf that you would designate him immortal to fight in your stead?
Well done, my son. You've given the beast a mortal wound. But let us hope she reaches the witch before she dies.
But why? Oh, Aslan.
So you all can follow her and rescue the other son of Adam. Oh, do not fear. Your strength will be in your numbers, as well as your faith to accomplish the task. The children will stay here with me.
I think she went this way. Here's a tall blood. She turned over the road to the grove tree. Quick, follow her.
You have forgotten to clean yourself? Now, hand it to me and kneel, son of Adam. Rise up, Sir Peter Fenris Bane. Your new name will tell the world that you were the destroyer of the evil old. Always maintain your courage. And never forget to wipe your sword.
Yes, Aslan.
Now, let us all go to the pavilion to await the others. If all goes well, they will return with your brother.
Let's go! young lady.